If you're studying for CCNA and want to know how to configure a simple OSPF network with just two routers, and in this video, I'm going to explain just that. Here I have two routers interconnected with Ethernet. All I have done so far, as you can see on these devices, is that I just configured the IP address on both site physical interfaces and loopback interfaces. And let's enable OSPF on this network and address R1's network to R2 and vice versa. Alright, let's get into the configuration mode. To enable OSPF, type the command router OSPF process ID 1. It doesn't really matter what process ID that you use, as this is locally significant. Now let's address all the network using the network command and use the area at the end. Network you have to use wildcard mask here. To find wildcard mask, subtract subnet 30 from 32 like this. So this is a subnet value, you have to subtract and you will get this value. The reason why I have used 30 subnet because it's a point-to-point link and it doesn't require more than 2 IPs. Area 0 is the backbone area and all the areas must connect it to the backbone area. And when I use the network command, it basically means I am addressing this particular interface to the OSPF network. Let's do the same thing on all the loopback interfaces as well. Now we are done with R1 configuration, OSPF configuration. Let's go back to R2. Configuration mode. I can also use the specific interface rather than the subnet by using the command 0.0.0.0 area 0. I haven't enabled OSPF on this router. Let's just do that. Use a command network. This, and let's do the configuration on loopback interface as well. As you can see, the logs, these are generated because the neighborship was created, has been created on this particular router. Now that's done, let's verify the connectivity. Let's do ping from R2 to R1's loopback address. Ping 1.1.1.1. Yes, I'm getting response. Let's do the same thing on R2 again. 4.3.4.4.1. That worked as well. Let's also check out some verification commands. Show IP route OSPF. Yes, OSPF routes are learned on this router. Let me check the neighborship as well. IP OSPF neighbor. Yes, I can see the neighborship being formed on R2 and this is R1's loopback address. Let's ping R2's loopback address. Yes, I can. I think I have configured a different IP here. Yes, that worked as well. If you would like more help with any other network related videos, please comment in the comment section below. And thanks for watching. Have a great day.